Hi, and welcome to our Open Stop Motion film project. We need to make the last four of these, or six. Yesterday we made a lot of other ones, and the green, the neon green, we have made with the clay clay in these where the wood touch the is glued on the printed part. So we need to make these last finish, and then we can go on to get them painted. Like I just painted this one, the first you can see standing on the cardboard and the turntable, and you can see there is a lot of trees now. You can see more from behind, but we need more, so we have to make the last of this series. Right, I need to get a knife. I forgot that. Cannot find your knife. Oops. Now I kicked it all. But I'm getting there with this bunch here. We will move it. You can see there are only hoops. Not that bad. Where do I? You can see. We only have six with this one left, so we will fix that, and then we can go and paint it. And before we know it, we will have all of them fixed. I need another thing. Then I have a whole box full of those I used plastic padding on. That was a bad idea compared to this, but that's how it goes. You get wiser along the way. And I don't get as much done as I wish during the day because I have a neck problem. That's right now, so. That don't help the speed of the production. You probably know there's always something. So, and always something. That's why we always take one day at a time. But now when we start to get some of the stuff finished, then we can, it's easier to see how, if I have to print more trees or I have to do one thing or another. In theory, I should have enough made already printed, but when you do stuff like this, then you, before you start, try to figure all of it out in your head, but you cannot do that. But anyway, you try. But it can only be guesses. If and when it's the first big movie you are trying to make, then you don't have enough experience to figure it out. But I already knew that from the start, and I also said so, that I will be making many errors on the way and do things in the wrong way. So, and that will be time consuming too. When you make a lot of stuff and then you have to paddle backwards, and that is what I try to avoid. And hopefully I can avoid too much of it. This is not very stable. Some of them I haven't glued that good. I probably have been too busy. Takes twice the time. easier to do it right the first time. I didn't. So, stop fiddling with it before it falls apart. Oh, this, that's the print. Of course, I have to get the glue gun again. I hope I didn't have to do that, but that's how it goes. And this glue gun is the most unhandy glue gun ever. Cannot recommend that one. I thought I would buy a really good one this time, and it is not. It is not. so next time we'll buy a cheap one. See if this is any better. That was the broken one. This is not. This is good enough. Now I've applied too much pressure on it. And then it breaks apart. This is an omen on what will happen the rest of the week, or the rest of the evening. Then I think it's best to stop now. Let's hope it's just a little rough start. One can hope. Grease on your fingers and finish. Here's the soup. Or glue strings. Whatever. So, we can dry them off afterwards. Shall we see if we can? Is it hot or not? It smells right. I have oil on my fingers. Okay. Let it dry a little and unplug, or let it let it chill a little, or what we call it. So we can handle it. But when we are finished with that one, we can go and paint on the other side. Give it a little more light that way. The sanding of those we have made with plastic padding we'll do in the workshop, so we don't have all the dust in here in the studio. But that's why we bought all these cameras, so you could do that. And I have a monitor in there, so but I kind of need one more over. Just drag it around instead of cutting it off. Wait a little. And then we have to put sticks, sticks like this on all of those over behind. I haven't put together yet, but we kind of finished a lot of those. Half finished job that is laying around. So when we come, I guess next week we will be finished with all of that, then we can get going. Start to get an idea of how I will arrange it on the table, the scenery, and if I have to print more trees or or what? But maybe I have. I don't know. But then we will do that. But I will make a. I don't think I will print. I will make, hand make a lot more in clay. So that I don't get too many of these. Ones. Time will tell. I'll see if you can cut this. Maybe this blade is too dull. Put a new one in. That is good enough. So, and then I have something up here. And then we have to make a lot of twigs with leaves on. When we are finished with all the trees. Because there is spring and we need leaves on the trees. Okay.
upper part. Shooting.
I don't hope it. They are shooting each other. Who knows? Who knows what they are up to? So they moved the worst grease, oily stuff, so it's a little easier to paint. Get the paint to stick on it. Water and oil are not always the best marriage. It sometimes ends in divorce. We cannot have that. Stuff. So then we go to the other camera, if I can figure it out here, and I will take the mic over there too. Oops. And move the camera so don't get seasick. Maybe we should try this today. This way. And a little brick. And a little up. I think this is okay. I need room. So, and then these ones go and get those. So I can see what I'm doing. What is it? We can see this. And mouse. And this one we will give one more time. As you probably can see, it's a little spotty. So. Tissue. Maybe we should. Put it down a little. And move it up a little. Now we should be ready. when I first did this one, it kind of looked like everything was covered. But now when I get the light on it, I can see that's not the case. I did this one in a hurry just before I went on so that it could dry before I got over here. So I could give it in one more time. This texture, there is a lot of grooves in it, so need to get paint in the down in them. So we don't have neon yellow looking through. That's not the way to do it. Need some more video head to the tripods. I only have one of the good video heads. This one with this camera on is only a cheap tripod. So there is no fluid movement on that. Like there is on the other one. Or where we just were. But I think every evening I tell you about something I want or need, or it's a never ending story. That's how it is. Good video heads is kind of expensive. That's maybe why I don't have a lot of them. But only one. See from under and up. Someone give me a hand. I think we got it more or less. So, how do we do then? Me, no kaboom. And then we paint this, but maybe I should take because yesterday it got weird when we, and now we can go a little. So, and if anybody comments in the chat room, I cannot see it from here. So I apologize. But I will answer afterwards. Anybody have any questions? And not just a question, what is this? Read and watch. Think that I think it kind of give itself away. without being a very difficult IQ test. The first living creature. Oopsie. Tomorrow, I will, maybe if I get time, I will try to scan one. Or I have several birds laying around, and I will try to scan them in. So we can get the printer going. So we can get some animals in the forest. Birds, stuff. And you can see we have a bear lurking around among the trees. So we need some prints. And the size of the trees are done after that. There is a limit to how small I can make the humans in going around in the forest. So I cannot make the tree smaller than this, and the humans have to be even smaller, then it's very difficult to animate them. Or make them animatable. You have to have joints and that sort of thing. I'm afraid to go smaller than this. But that's not built on experience, but more like built on assumptions. Yeah. You have to take a guess sometime. How one. How and why you will do it. And of course you can be very wrong. And it will be bad if my thoughts and assumptions will be wrong at this point. Then I can put all of these in a trash can. I could take the phone away. I forgot that. But that could happen. Never know. When stuff don't work, as it's oops, why? Somebody haven't put clay on this one. I have to do that. Yep. Do that later. But if that's happened, then I just have to start all over. Nothing to do else. But let's hope that will not be the case. Nothing serious. So just maybe we should start singing. I'm a lumberjack. I am. Oh, best. Stop that. With that beautiful voice of mine. I started to do that, the birds that has just arrived from Africa here to my country, they will flew back. So Just let that be. Don't rub it now. I just have to leave you a second. So yeah, I'll get my coffee. See. There is so much stuff around that's hard to get place for more stuff. But that's how it is, I guess. Oh, I think you say get room for more stuff. Oops. The reason I often say that's wrong, that is because in my language, Danish, we say plads and place. That's the same thing, but we kind of use it a little different. And always there it gets a little difficult with language where we have words kind of similar. We have another our grammar are different. Our when you are and I'm speaking English, then I have a tendency to translate more or less like a Google translation, to that you if I think it on Danish, and then I take every word in that order I think it, and then I translate every single word to English, but then it comes out in the wrong order, because you don't do it like that, those of you who speak English. That's how it is. that's a good thing about the net, that is that kids nowadays hear and use English all the time, and they even learn in the early age in the school. They also get to use it. When I was a kid, I have never seen and foreigner, whatever language. Oh, that's not true. My father worked with one from Switzerland, but we didn't travel that much, a lot back then. So, and on the telly there was only one, or TV as the Americans say, there was only one channel, and that was a national channel. So and the first foreign channels we got was, where I lived, was German channels, because I lived my childhood near the border to Germany. So pretty soon I understood German as good as I understood Danish. Still today I do that. Yeah, not. I'm of course a little rusty because it's many years ago, but I still don't have any problem understanding them. But then of course when you don't speak it, that you lose if you don't keep on doing it. And of course, foreigner always laugh at or Americans always laugh at English people speaking like they do, and probably laughing at me and my weird way of English, and but. Of course, it must sound funny to them, and I would probably laugh at their Danish if they tried, but I guess that's non-existent, their Danish. Most foreigners think Denmark is a capital in Sweden or something. That's how it is. but even in a small country like ours, people are kind of laughing off each other because we have a lot of, not so much anymore, but just 20 years back, there was a lot of dialects. Heard people from other places in the country. They thought that they sound funny. Even them themselves sound funny. But that they couldn't hear. We have most fun when we laugh at others. But sometimes we need to have the ability to laugh at ourselves. But that's not always our strong side. And the fun part is that we are pretty much the same, all of us, wherever we come from. Egypt or US or Africa or whatever. There is not much difference. We have different upbringing and different experience, but be pretty much the same anyway. And do laugh of pretty much the same stuff too. But you have to be a little careful with humor when it's because it sometimes have another meaning for people from other parts of the world. And no reason to offend anybody. And one more. But the more I make, the more I think I have to make. You can see. I don't know how many you can see. But there are a lot, but we have a lot there, but we also have a big area too. To cover. Not entirely, but maybe there is enough, I don't know. I don't know. I was living once where there were this 1600 square meters barn, and I could use that now. I don't think the building exists anymore. It will be crazy expensive to rent or buy. Even in these times. And is a lot of space around standing unused, but there, those with a lot of money have bought those and just waiting on the times to get better, and then they will sell. And there is a lot of space in the inner city. They are also just waiting on the time to, because there's a lot of shops that's gone down. There are a lot of empty shops. But they don't know that is those times will not come back in that form, at least. So. But they still wait. So, and hope they can get the same for it that they once did, but they will not, because they, all the shops are moving out from inner town and in bigger malls and that sort of thing, and a lot more business will go on the net in the future. So, where there was a little bookstore or something before, brick and mortar store, they will slowly disappear. Kind of a shame, I think, but I'm afraid that will happen. It will take time, but I'm afraid it will happen. Slowly but surely. And we will buy our stuff on Amazon or net shops like that. Nearly all the stuff I buy from the net. Except for the grocery. Rest I buy from the net. And I would like to buy it locally, but on the other hand, I don't want to pay a lot more money for it locally than I have to pay on the net. I cannot afford to do it that way, just to keep the shops running. And I have bought tripods and that sort of thing locally, but Really expensive. Then I also think us guys are more willing to buy stuff on the net because we are not that eager to go shopping. Except from the home improvement store, where you can buy tools and stuff. But even those have more and more everything else that could tools. Most of my tools I also have bought on the net, because they don't have them locally. And when I go down to them, then they have to order it home, and they order it from the same guy that I do. And then I have to pay them for that. So I cannot see any idea in that. So best to do it yourself. I miss the old type of hardware store where you even they were really small comparison to the modern one, but that they had everything you could think of. Now they have pictures and coffee machines and whatnot, candy bars and ice cream and maybe they have to do that to survive. I don't know. I have never owned a store. But in this little town we still have, this town is about 40,000 people. But we still have a electronic store where you can go and buy a transistor, resistor, whatnot. He have it. That's an old man, so I think when he stops, that will go too. Condenser and what? There's no limit. So there must still be people around in garage or sheds in the garden who build electronic stuff themselves or repaired. Nasty fingers. I didn't snack. And you are welcome to a bite. I know that was not nice. To tempt you. Okay. Especially if you don't have any ice cream in your freezer. These days are pretty long days, so a little sugar trip can help a little. Be careful. Thank you. Was it 25 or 26 we had here, I think. So, and these are finished. And we have 50 of these fiddle trees. Oh, 50 something. Then with the, there should be hundreds around. So with that amount, I should get a pretty good picture of how many I will need. More if I need more of those. I think we are close to have to make some more paint. That part start to being empty. We have more. I hope. But we use a lot. So, next one. I think this will be the last one before we need to make some more paint. See the bottom of it. I don't hope it rains tomorrow. I hope I can get these given some more, the last two paint and then some lacquer. But lacquer I do outdoors spray. On the balcony. So, and the pot is kind of empty. So, we will put some more in. I can never find my stuff. It's because I move it around all the time. Here it is. Because when we are finished here at night, I have to move it. So I can get room for a lot of other stuff. There are some trees, in any case, around here. Paper towel. So now we should be able to get the last one done, the last ones done with an S. Cool. Seven. This is number 7 of the last. It's cold. It always gets cold. Have to be careful not to squeeze it where the clay is. Well, I have to hold it somehow. Maybe I put a little too much water in this. Stick on the oily bits. It will, sooner or later. Yeah. And there are only 6 left. Standing on a cable. Thank you. It is a little thin. That's how it ended up being. I was too generous with the water. And we can glue again. That's how it goes when you're tired. And you are cheapskate because these are pretty much hollow inside in the print, so to stretch the plastic a little, but we are not doing that anymore. Because when they tilt, then they break. The print has to be absolutely perfect if you are making them totally hollow, or not 100% hollow, but very much so. And then when the extruder are not good, then I'll get that problem. And these are printed while the extruder was breaking down on his last leg. Then the layer don't fuse good enough together. And I kept turning the temperature up and up and up and up. But it didn't. At last. So we got a new one. From United States of America. I will you can see it's hollow inside here, the twig. So I will make a glue gun ready. Oops. So we can fix it and hope we don't break anymore. When we are finished with them all, we'll put them all in a box so we don't keep on breaking them until we have to use them, until we start to put leaves on them. But we will build the scenery first, the that next time we touch them, we will put them on the finally resting spot. We don't keep fumbling around with them. Careful now. and then I'll buy a lot of this stuff to build up the level. Make some hills and so on. So it will be a little more interesting landscape. And then I will model the last trees and whatnot after I have made the landscape. So maybe I will make a few trees before, but it's a good thing to have the landscape so I can model the tree after the landscape, how it kind of looks. We get a little harmony in that. System. So that the final pictures look good. Make a good composition and the right proportions and so on. Make it believable. not all about just getting some animation figures, it's also the scenery and the pictures of the scenery, the light and so on, that makes it I don't know if any of you have seen Paranorma with Leica made that. That's a good one. Stop motion. Or they have also made Box Trolls. These guys are really good at it. And if you haven't seen any of them, I will suggest that you do, because it's really very well made and funny too, and humor is a very important part of something like that too. It is extremely well made. But they also use some computer generated stuff in it, but it's still fantastic. don't fall. I'm tired of gluing everything. So, you will go to the glue room. So, we will let it dry while I run for a second. So, Who took my scalpel? Yes. Admit so and this is the last one and then we only have to give it two times more. Sorry. But that's how it is. So is anyone out there say this is boring? The only thing I can say to that, how do you think it is to do it? So don't cry. I can, you are not allowed to. You can only have pity on me. And consider if you are going to make a stop motion movie with a wood in it. There's a forest in it. I would suggest you make one that goes on in Sahara or something. A lot of sand. Make a story about a lizard in Sahara. In the desert somewhere. That must be much easier. I have never been good at making it easy for myself. I guess now it's too late to learn. I guess this is my last big project. Oops. After this, I will sit slowly back in my chair and die and say thank you for this time. Maybe read a book or two before. I don't know. maybe I've been so smitten by this that I think I can make one more. Who knows? So that was the first time from all of them. And I guess that's the first one I made dry enough now to give them the second time. This will be another color. This one color, I will make it a little darker, put some red in it. I was not happy with that last time. Let's see how that looks. A little more of this. I think we very soon need to get a new one of these. That's the color I use. It feels a little light. You're getting paint all over the place. Oh. see how it dries up. It's always getting a little darker when it dries. So, oopsie, don't hit my tree. I think this is fine. Because the trees may differ in color, this looks best when I do that. They get a gray one at last, but I think I will need all of this so I can have the trees over here when I'm that far in the project. Take these. Oh. Then I have room for them. Yep. Down in the knees. And up again. I'll take a piece of paper or cardboard. That's a tablecloth. Walking around in here is the same as in circus, where you can see a lady is able to crawl in a very little box. Snake woman or something they call them. At least that's what they call them here. And I'm kind of the snake man. So, don't even think of it. Light a smoke while I'm doing it. Sorry, I should not advertise for that, but it slipped. No, I will put some more water in this because it covers pretty good. I don't want that. That was what I wanted before, but not now. Because I wanted the darker stuff to look through. put some more water in it. We wanted it a little more transparent. So it gets a little more different colors. Even this is not enough. A couple of more. Fill it up. So now it has to be enough. It's always depend on what what color it is. Some of the colors are, you can see the little square, that's covered, paint cover. This is half, it's a triangle, it's only half covering. So, what do you call it? I don't remember much. I'm sure you know what I mean. And I put a lot of that red one in here that was covering, so and the white is also a mixing color, they're calling it mixing white, if you can read what's on there. So that's why it's a little different how you blend it. It's okay to cover the green stuff, but it's not okay to cover all this. If you, next time you are in the woods or out in your garden and have a tree there, you can see that they are many, many colors. Gray, green tones and dark. this color is the same one you make what we in old days did with oil painting, but nowadays we do it with acrylic. Because we will not have the brain destroyed by the fumes from turpentine and whatnot. And these colors what are we calling that? They are not getting the color are not what is the name for that? They can stand the light. A lot of cheap colors when there comes light on them, then they disappear kind of. What is that? You know, you have, if you try to print if you try to print pictures with cheap ink, and then you're hanging on the wall and the sun is if there is light on the place where you hang them, then they will get the colors will fade, but it will not with these colors. They are, and that's why they are kind of expensive comparison to other stuff. It's not a good idea to hang a paint on the wall and you have spent hours and days and months making, and then a year after it's hard to see the colors on it. But it's always, whatever color it is, it always a good good thing to kind of hang you are if you are taking pictures and get them printed in lots and hang them on the wall. It's always a good thing to kind of not hang them in direct sunlight. Let them have a little shadow. That's the best thing, regardless that they say that they can hold for 100 years. They are full of it. They cannot. That's this. There's no cost to say that because they are long gone and before you come and complain. And you can also, I have seen around, you can buy lacquer. You can give you pictures you can you can you can spare them the UV light, but you cannot. That's also bogus. It can take a little, but and if you don't believe me, cut a little piece of that's the way I do it. Cut a little piece of something you printed with a color on, and then give it that some lacquer, then tape it to the window and see how fast it will disappear, the color. That's the way I test colors when I'm in doubt if they have to. If I am doing, in olden days when I did stuff for a customer, then I ensured that they wouldn't disappear. As old as I am, then you have experienced a lot of stuff that should hold forever. That will never fail, this lifelong guarantee. It haven't held my time out, at least. So I must have lived longer than life. But I guess you know all of that. Have been there, tried that. I forgot this one. Have to have some clay on down here before I give it this last. you can see, we will not be finished with this tonight. Finish with it tomorrow. It's a big job. Sticky. I think this one is the last one for tonight. See how much I get done before I get on again tomorrow. So we will move over here to close, and I'll take the mic with me without destroying anything if I can't. And of course the mouth too. Turn the screen around so I can see where I am. And we didn't break any more of this, so we can untie the glue gun. Oops. And then of course all this glue to the ground.
So,
and now this one stopped working. But now it's working again. But in 1 minute it's midnight here, so I will once again say thank you and good night, and hope I'll see you again tomorrow.